An ideal Otto cycle that uses helium as the working fluid has a compression ratio of 9. Before compression, the helium is at 100 kilopascals and 280 Kelvin. If 680 kilojoules per kilogram of heat are transferred to the helium during the constant volume heat addition process, what is the thermal efficiency of the cycle? As always, pause here and try solving this yourself before watching the solution. This is the second example for the Otto cycle main lecture. The link to that 10-minute lecture and the links to all the other lectures of the thermal course are found in the description below. The thermal efficiency of these cycles is always defined as the usable energy out over the energy in. This means that it's the net specific work out over the specific heat in. We were given Qin, but we have to find Wnet. From energy conservation, we see that the net work out, which would be the work coming out at the expansion minus the work needed at the compression, is equal to the difference between Qin and Qout. The Qin term we have, and we have to calculate Qout. Since the heat coming out is that after the expansion, we would have U4 minus U1. And since in this case we have helium, which has constant specific heats, we can write it in terms of CV and temperatures. From this expression, we're missing T4. Because state 4 is right after the expansion, and that expansion is isentropic, we can use the isentropic relationships we developed in the reference entropy 12-minute lecture, link below. We would do this between 3 and 4. This is the volume to temperature relationship of the then labeled approximate analysis. And we use this one because we have the volume ratio, and we can find T3 just like we did in the previous example. We follow the exact same steps explained in the first example on this topic, link below if you haven't studied it yet, and we find T3. Now with T3 and the specific heats ratio K that we looked up during that process, we substitute them in the T4 expression to find T4. We then use that temperature to calculate the heat out, and with it, the net work out. And since the thermal efficiency is W net over Qin given, we substitute the values to find the thermal efficiency of this cycle. If you want to check out other Otto cycle examples, including what the mean effective pressure means, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermal course, as well as other playlists for engineering courses. Thanks for watching!